Hi guys, today we are going to look at model validation matrices. If we look at, we should be in the position to interpret this all in order to take certain decision. R square, you should know. Adjusted R square, you should know. Next, you should know intercept, the square fit coefficient. Intercept, you should know. Standard error. Then you should know confidence interval. The range, upper confidence and lower confidence interval, p-value, t-stat. So t-statistics. So all together, you should be in the position to interpret. Let us see one by one. So when it comes to r-square, so this is coefficient of determination. Otherwise, r-square is called coefficient of determination. What is the value of r-square? Always it should be between 0 to 1. Better the value. See, 1 indicates a perfect fit. All data points lie on the regression line. So this should be applicable both for testing and training. Only then you can say perfect model. Otherwise, overfitting is a problem you will face. 0 indicates no relationship exists between two variables. That is the meaning. 1 indicates the perfect relationship. So it lies, all the points lies on the line itself. See, I am dropping a line, you can't even notice. So this lies on the line. So how much deviation it has, every point, how much deviation? See, the deviation that all shows, that residual values shows the lesser R square value. More and more the deviation, lesser the R square. So how this you can prove? You can prove this using standard error. So this standard error will help us to understand the cause or reason for the lesser R square value. Next, adjusted R square. What is the meaning is number of explanatory variable and the sample size both will play a role. What is the meaning is rows and columns, number of rows, N, columns, number of columns involved, all together it will play a role. Let us say for example, M. These two together considered all along with the residual deviations, it is considered. So that is the reason adjusted R square is always useful for comparing the model. What is the meaning of comparing the model is when you remove one variable or when you add one variable, after the removal, after the inclusion of one variable into the regression model fitting, you can compare model 1, model 2. Similarly, rows also, records also, how many records you are retaining, how many records you are removing. If you look at the very first case, nonlinear regression, we have discussed January 2007, we have removed all the data before to the 2000. The because lot of fluctuation after 2000 January only, there was a steady increase in the change in value. So that in this case, before this removal of rows, after the removal of rows, which is the model or which is the matrix will be reliable? Adjusted R square is a reliable matrix. Okay, actual perception, although it does not give the actual perception of variation explained by model as R square does. It is useful when comparing this model, that's all. So this is for exact perception. R square will be helpful for understanding the percentage of explanation. For example, if you get 0.6, what that signifies is 60% of the time the model is reliable and it could able to predict something. That is the meaning. Whereas R adjusted R square, you cannot use it as like the reliability of R square. However, R square can be used for model comparison. Whenever you are eliminating certain number of rows, whenever you are eliminating certain number of columns, or whenever you are including columns and rows, that situation adjusted R square would be much more better or efficient. Next, standard error is always useful for variability of the observed y values from the predicted values. So this is always useful for understanding the variability, variations. between the observed value and the predicted value. So that is the meaning. So formally, standard error of the estimate SYX, this is represented with SYX. So let us see one by one. Now, interpreting regression statistics. What is regression statistics? These all together, it is said to be regression statistics. So you see, first multiple R, R square, adjusted R square, standard error, then ANOVA. So these all together, regression statistics, we need to go ahead. So now, what is the first thing you are going to interpret? Look at here, home market value, simple linear regression. So only one variable only you will have. We see that the intercept is 32.67. What is intercept 32.673? intercept, see here, 32.673 coefficient. Look at here. So they are converting it into percentage, 32.673. So this is what intercept value or coefficient value. Slope coefficient of the independent variable, square feet. Next, 35.036. What is that? Let us see. That is intercept and coefficient of the variable. 35.036. Here, you need to look at here. So this is intercept value. You need to convert it into percentage representation, 32.673. When you are comparing this slope, it is direct. So 35.03. So these two you are interpreting. So after that, you need to look at R square. This means approximately 53% of the variation is explained by this home market value. So this variable, home market value, it will explain. The remaining variation is due to other factors. What is that other factors? Less than the variation around the sample mean. Why it is becoming lesser R square is the question mark. Because of the deviations, variations or deviations. How to calculate that variation and deviations, we may need to understand through standard error. So this is the interpretation report you need to consider. Why this R square is reduced this much? The reason is variation. Why that variation has come? That we may not able to judge because it is the data. What is the source of data we need to understand from in which we can proceed. But whatever may be, the reduction in R square is the cause of variation. In general, in the machine learning, they used to say this as a noise in data. That is what they call noisy data, noise in data. In general, they will give this definition. So what is that noise in data? Through statistics only, you can understand step by step. That noise in data is called variation. Variation around the sample mean. Look at here. Less than the variation around the sample mean. So that variation we are going to understand now. So next is ANOVA. If you look at here, ANOVA, the section called ANOVA, 1 minute. Look at here, ANOVA. Here, F statistics value is used for interpretation. We no need to worry about too much in every formula and every calculation. Just let us look into the interpretation. Now, what is the purpose of hypothesis or how we need to formulate hypothesis for the linear regression? We need to set null hypothesis as slope of the independent variable is zero. What is the meaning? Slope of the independent variable is zero means, look at here. Independent variable slope becomes zero, then it will align to the horizontal line. It will be equal to the horizontal line, parallel to the horizontal line. Then if it is parallel to the horizontal line, it cannot explain the variability. When you can explain, when there is a slope, some other slope other than zero, then change in X related to change in Y, you can predict. That is what linear regression you are doing. Change in X is always helpful to predict change in Y. But when the slope becomes equal to zero or horizontal line, there is no explanation. Never change in x will be helpful for explaining about change in y. There is no use of this line. So that we are trying to tell null hypothesis leads to zero. What is alternate hypothesis? It is not zero. Slope does not become zero. That is a claim we are using in this hypothesis testing when it becomes linear regression, especially simple linear regression. This is the scenario. Next, how this F test is useful? You need to find out the p value for the F test, significance of the F. You need to interpret the F value is greater than typically we less than means we need to reject. Let us consider if it is greater than 0.05, 95% confidence interval. If it is greater than, we can accept alternate hypothesis. Look at here, F test value. So this is what F significance, 3.79 something, it is available. If you look at here, so if it becomes greater than, then you can conclude that your alternate hypothesis becomes evident. You are rejecting null hypothesis. Comparing to p-value, what is the p-value? 95% confidence interval if you are setting, then 0.05 would become your p-value. Then naturally, if it f-test becomes greater than p-value, you need to accept alternate hypothesis and you need to reject null hypothesis. This is how you need to write hypothesis testing for linear regression. So through simple linear regression, we are trying to understand all the intricacies related to this. Next, ANOVA test. Whenever you are considering ANOVA test, again you need to consider null hypothesis, alternate hypothesis, then the value of F test, F significance becomes greater than the set p value, you need to accept. The same repetition only here. Next, t test. You need to calculate t test. One sample t test for the mean. We are using one sample. So that we need to go for this formula. Slope minus 0 divided by standard error. This is the formula you may need to think for or use it for t-test calculation. This is another way to interpret result. Now let us consider what is this standard error. This you all know. This is a slope. What you are getting from the calculation, that b1 value, coefficient value only you are substituting here. Then minus 0 divided by standard error. You may need to understand the standard error. In order to that understanding, I will just move to the second tab. Could you able to understand, see the screen calculating standard error step? Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So here what you need to do is, in order to find out standard error, you need to start with the standard deviation. Then you need to move on to the standard error. In order to find out standard deviation, look at this is your variable. Height is your variable, let us imagine. Then what you need to find out? You need to find out the mean of the height. You need to start here. Yeah, 1 minute, it is not, pen is not supported. So look at here. You need to calculate mean of this height column. From the mean, you need to find out deviation, mean and measurement deviation. Then you need to square it. After squaring, you need to go for summation. That summation is 74. Look at here. What is the formula says? Xi minus mu. Every point need to be subtracted with the mean value and squared divided by n minus 1. So degrees of freedom, n minus 1, 13 minus 1, it produces this value. Then you need to substitute that value into standard deviation divided by square root of n. Number of points are 13. Look at player number. 13 points are, 13 samples are there, so 13. So finally 0.69. This is how you need to calculate standard error. What else we can do? We need to find out 95% confidence interval for the data. If you learn in addition to the standard error, this also how to find out confidence interval, that would be much more better. So what is the way we need to calculate? Let us look into this step. So now weight in pounds. So player number, weight in pounds. Again the same, you need to calculate the mean value. From the mean value, you need to find out mean minus measurement. The mean value is around 180. I have one Excel sheet also. If you wish, I can show subsequently. So 180, the mean value of this. So from that, you are calculating mean minus measurement. Then you are calculating the square value. Then what you are trying to do? You are just substituting, plugging into the formula. Xi minus mu the whole square divided by n minus 1. Sigma is equal to, sigma is this. Then confidence interval, how you need to calculate is the question. You need to substitute this sigma to the standard error. What is the standard error formula? Square root of this divided by sigma, square root of sigma divided by 1 minute. Sigma divided by square root of n. So we need to calculate, we know what is sigma, 15 divided by square root of n. What square root of n is 10. So 15 divided by square root of 10, if you put, what is the value you would be getting is 5.0226. This is what your standard error. You need to substitute that standard error with 1.96. That is a value, set sigma value, z value, for the confidence interval 95%. This is what we discussed in unit 1. So that you need to multiply. This 1.96 is constant. This is available in the table. 95% z value for the set confidence interval is 1.96. This is what your standard error. You need to multiply these two. Then these two you need to add and you need to subtract from the mean value. I said that the mean value is 180. The minute calculation also is available in Excel. If you wish, you can do, or you yourself can practice. So that mean value, if you add and subtract from this, you will be getting the interval 171.7557 to 191.443 pounds. So this is how you can calculate the confidence interval using standard error. So this, within this it lies, always the pound value lies between these two range. So that is what suitable range. Through this calculation we are concluding suitable range. You hope so you would be remembering credit card. I was illustrating one of the sample. So in that credit card limit, I want to give you limit based on your profile, based on your CIBIL score, or based on your past history. Then how can I set the credit value range minimum to maximum? So if you look at credit card, there are different credit cards available. Every credit card, they will be setting the range or the value. Credit limit, lower credit limit to higher upper credit limit. So how they decide is based on the profile of the person, based on the nature of the card, then they will calculate statistically. They will come out with upper limit and the lower limit. There are two different ways. One is for the card, there will be some limit, upper to lower. Depending upon your profile only, they will give you the credit amount minimum to maximum. So how they decide for every cardholder? Based on statistical measures, based on CIBIL score, or based on their current salary, or based on all those things, or based on all other loan which they have availed. Everything is linked with the PAN card. So everything will be reflected. Pledging the gold, personal loan, and home loan, all other loan, credit card loan, any other credit card loan, all will be integrated together. So once if these all the parameters are collected, through in which they can able to set these intervals, how they can able to give. So this is how credit card mechanism, that interval setting also they are doing. So using this standard error, let us go. So you would be getting what is standard error, then what is statistics, 6.78. So this is what the obtained. Again, we are going back to t statistics. So you need to compare with the p-value. If it is becoming greater than, then you can go with alternate hypothesis, or you can accept null hypothesis. So that is how it works. Now again we are going back to the confidence interval. Look at here, confidence interval. So how they are calculating? From that 1750, this is what estimated that a house with a square feet has a market value. First you need to go with the this confidence interval. We no need to calculate. It is given by the R report 1450. It is given. What else we need to do is the question. Standard error we need to calculate or we need to consider. Let us go back to that. Note down 14 and 50. How the confidence interval is calculated, that is what I was explaining using there. Now we are going for, look at here, home market value, 95% confidence interval for the intercept is this. Similarly, 95% confidence interval for the slope. What is the slope? We need to include that slope influence. For that, we need to find out, that is 2445. Let us go back and interpret this confidence interval. One is 14 and another one is 50. Next one is 24, another one is 45. We need to interpret that. Look at here. Confidence interval 14 for the intercept. Upper limit 50. Square feet, it is given. This is one variable. Then another one is intercept. So 2445. Yes, it is available. This is how the confidence interval we may need to interpret. Finally, what is the use of this confidence interval is for the decision making. Decision making with a 95% confidence interval, these are all the range we need to consider. That is the meaning you need to interpret. This lower confidence interval, upper confidence interval will guide us for the decision making based on regression analysis. So we need to provide business value or we need to provide business solution while it is useful. In order to provide business solution, it is useful. Look at that. The same confidence interval only, it is reflected here. Look at here. 24, 45, 14, 50. Next, you need to form the equation. How you form the equation? This 32, 35 also available in that report, R report, statistical report. Next, what you are going to do, interval suggests bit of uncertainty. Although we estimated that the house with 1750 square feet, if at all, you can predict. How you can predict any house? See, you can even own the house of 3000 square feet also. You need to plug in this value to this equation. That will give you the price of the house. This is how it is helpful in predicting the price of the house. Similarly, next, you need to put for both of the interval. Look at here. One is 1424, another one is 5045. So next, $57,855 to $130,113. This is a range. Narrower confidence interval provide more accuracy in our prediction. What finally you are going to interpret is, what is the price you can fix based on the historical house sale. Historical house sale means how other seller and buyers are selling the house. Depending upon the circumstances, depending upon other vendors or other houses, you can fix the best price between this. It gives the indication, the minimum to the maximum. This is how linear regression helpful in the business analysis. Or business analytics, or in order to provide the decision making. So far now, we understood what are all the parameters we need to interpret, then how we need to take the confidence interval. This also not 100%, 95% confidence interval only we have set. From the 95% confidence interval, we have arrived this range. Narrower confidence interval provide more accuracy in our prediction. Now, this is not narrower confidence interval. This is, the interval is too huge. It is not narrower. Because why this is becoming huge? Your R square itself not perfect, 53% only. Next, what else we can see? This is a residual plot. Residual plot does not form any pattern. It is scattered. So, this is accepted or as per underlying assumption, whatever we have predicted is reliable somewhat. We need to concentrate on model improvement techniques subsequently, interpreting residual output. So you can just go ahead with this residual output interpretation. Now let us move on to checking assumptions, linearity. First you need to form that equation should become linear relationship first, that is linearity. So next is what? Examining residual plot, see how scatter diagram of the data or examining the residual plot. How you can check this linearity is you can go for residual plot. Residual plot should not form any pattern, then that is linearly available, it has linear trend. Next, normality of error. What you need to do, all the error you need to plot. So this is what, whatever the error value, array of error, you will have array of error, y minus y cap, what is your actual value and the predicted value, you will be finding the difference, that you will be recording here. It could be 1, 2, 3 or with a floating value also, whatsoever may be, you will have that values, you may need to plot it. While plotting, it should resemble more or less normal distribution. Although it is slightly skewed, but it takes a pattern of called normal distribution, more or less, so that it is permitted. So what is the final message you need to interpret is normality of error. Entire residual error you need to plot, it should take more or less the normal distribution. If not, something going wrong in the model building, so it is not reliable, we need to revisit or rebuild the model. This is second assumption. Every linear regression should satisfy these all. Only then you can interpret. So next is homoscedasticity. What is homoscedasticity? Based on the error or residual plot, it should not take any pattern. That is the meaning. This also, with respect to error only, they are taking lot of major decisions. So we need to be careful with residual plot. See, residual plot, large differences in the variations are different values for the independent variable. It should not have any pattern. Next, independence of error. All look at these all related to error, residual error. What that independence of error? For this, only one method is called autocorrelation. In the forecasting also, we are going to look at autocorrelation. That time we can discuss a little bit of detail. Durbin-Watson statistics test is used for autocorrelation analysis. What it says, just you need to plug into this, the given the data or that residual data. Yeah, error residual, you need to plug into this formula. What you need to have, you need to interpret is, finally, the autocorrelation value will range between 0 to 4. This is for sure. This is the maximum range. If it is less than 1, that is full autocorrelation or the best autocorrelation. The next is 1.5 to 2.5 is no autocorrelation. So now our value should become no autocorrelation. So this one, 1.5 to 2.5. Above 2.5 is negative autocorrelation. So our value or the value which we are obtaining for the data analysis should become within this no autocorrelation. That's it. See, residuals should be independent for each value of the independent, it should be independent. Independent means no autocorrelation. No autocorrelation should exist. That is the meaning. So next, the based on all, these all satisfied. Although R square value is lesser, these all satisfied. Although these all satisfied, why lesser R square value? Because of more standard error. When standard error will become more, whenever there is a noise or variability is more in the data, noise is more in the data, or variability is more in the data. What is the meaning of variability? Always you will be calculating mean, then you are finding xi minus y, the mean difference. Then the mean difference is more for every point, then you have more standard error. In order to avoid this, what we used to do in the machine learning, could you able to answer anyone, either chat window or in audio note? So this, in order to avoid standard error, we will be doing one of the method in the machine learning. I even explained what we used to do for reducing this standard error or noise removal. What we used to do. Could you able to relate? What point which we discussed is related to elimination of noise? Or in order to reduce the standard error, what we supposed to do? Or what we used to discuss in the machine learning? Any answer or a known is there? What generally we used to do in order to reduce the standard error? Here we are calculating from the error report or with the R report, linear regression report through we are discussing. Before even this all, we used to do something. What we used to do? I need to roll call, that's all. 804, 801, 812, 803, 811. What we used to do in order to reduce the standard error? Lot of pre-processing technique we used to do, no? What is the one of the pre-processing techniques related to this?
Distributions, yeah. Binomial, mean calculation.
Cleaning, what you will do? That and all, exploratory analysis. What you will do for reducing the standard error? This much micro level I'm explaining. Even then you are not able to tell. There is a variable you are calculating.
Actually, from the imbalance data set, we need to collect the data, ma'am, first.
No. Outlier elimination. That is what helpful. Could you able to connect with that why we are doing outlier elimination? This mean deviation becomes more. Could you get my point? All of only one student 100 or 0, rest all less than 50. Then this, because of 100, what will happen? This x minus mu would become more. When this becomes more, then standard error naturally will become huge. So when the standard error is more, your naturally R square value will become what? Lesser. When R square value becomes lesser, your reliability of the model, although it satisfies all the underlying assumptions, these all underlying assumptions, linearity, normality of error, homoscedasticity, independence of error. Why you are facing that lesser R square is because of standard error. Why that standard error is more? Because of the noise. What is that noise? Outlier. Ritually, if you study outlier, there is no use of outlier. You need to understand how that outlier is influencing your R square or the entire model. That entire model, the reliability will be reduced. In order to increase the reliability of the model, you need to eliminate outlier. That we will be doing beginning. In order to understand machine learning, you need to first build the model as such without cleaning anything. Understand what is the statistical report. Then you need to go for cleaning the model. Then you can clearly able to sensitize how much variation it happens after each and every cleaning process. Then what is the necessity of that cleaning? If not, what will happen? That cause and effect you can able to understand pretty much easier. Could you able to get, guys? Ritually, if you do, given the data, missing value imputation, given the data, outlier removal, then building the model, then you cannot learn anything. So you need to understand from this report. Next, multiple linear regression. So where in which they have considered more number of variables, independent variable. In the previous case, only one independent variable. Here, more independent variable. That's all. SAT, acceptance, expenditures, then top 10 HS. This is what they are considering. Graduation is the field they are going to consider. Predictions. Graduation is numerical. So then they are considering these all. Median SAT, acceptance rate, expenditure students, top 10 HS. So these are all the field they are considering. Type they are removing, school they are removing. Because school never ever will be helpful, influential in predicting your achievements. Then type, which course you are doing. So that is not required. So finally, based on these three parameters, they will be constructing median acceptance rate. These four, I guess, four or three. Yeah, four. Based on those four, they are finding out graduation score or percentage. So when you look at here, what is the point here in this? The rest all the same. See, R square is 53 initially. Then they will be removing. Look at here, R square is 53. They don't do any cleaning process. Then they will be going for residual plot. This also satisfies heteroscedasticity. There is no pattern. It is scattered plot. But what is a problem exists is, slowly if you look at, see, this is what, that is over. Yeah, that is over. Next, another data they are considering. Median years education, median income, median home value, median house wealth, based on that average balance. This they will be considering, from in which they are going to tell R square 94, adjusted R square also 94. Although it gives 94, is it possible to rely on that? How to identify the best regression method is the next question. 94. For this, they are going for multicollinearity check. This multicollinearity check only you can build the best model. How they are checking? If you look at all the parameters, they are finding out correlation. This is what theoretically I discussed. Now, visually, I am showing to you. Correlation, you have six parameter, the same parameter with the same parameter. When you do correlation, naturally, it will become one. That is no surprise. Leave about that. What else you need to look at? See, this is shaded area here. This one shaded area. High correlation. Normally 0.7 and above, it is treated as high correlation. Normally, in general. Look at home value and education. These two are highly correlated. Wealth and income. These two are highly correlated. So you need to take decision whether you need to retain home value or you need to retain education here with respect to these two parameters. Then with respect to these two parameters, whether you need to retain wealth or you need to retain income, you need to go for iteration. If you want to avoid iteration, you need to find out AAC, AKAIKA information criteria. You need to find out. Otherwise, this is also one of the tedious tasks. And doing iteration is also one of the tedious tasks. Then how you need to build the model? Home value and wealth. This is the parameter you can retain and you can build the model. Then another, there is no conflict of interest. What are all other variables? Age doesn't have any other problem. Where the problem you started finding it? Between home value and education, wealth and income. So you need to form this combination, home value, wealth and age. Next, education and income and age. Then only two possible models. That's all, nothing more. Iteration one, iteration two. You can take the best decision based on the standard error or based on the error value, where you can take decision. That's it. So this is how you need to consider. Normally, these all the check, there are two ways. When you learn, these all can be done later on understanding the error. When you are doing, you need to go for missing value imputation. Next, you need to go for immediately outlier elimination. You need to go for multicollinearity check. Then you need to go for correlation, independent variable and dependent variable correlation. That is different scenario. This is considering it is useful for feature selection, whereas these all said to be independent variable and independent variable. IV and IV correlation analysis. This IV-IV correlation analysis is meant for multicollinearity. IV and DV correlation analysis is meant for feature selection. More and more the correlation, suppose between two different variable, one of the independent variable, one of the independent variable, the correlation is 0.003. It is not at all required. It is useless. This variable cannot explain anything. This is 3% only it could be able to explain for the prediction. So we can eliminate. So this is how you can do the feature selection also, because there is no relationship exists between certain or chosen the independent variable and the dependent variable. So for that purpose, we will be doing this. So like thumb rule, we can do everything and we can build the model, or without doing these all, just with the original data, given data set, you can build the model and you can understand, you can do reliability check and you can do all other thing. Otherwise, these are all the minimum. Madam, 1 minute, madam, please close the door. Pranita, madam, could you close the door? So you need to do two things. One is missing value imputation, outlier reduction, multicollinearity, and you need to go for correlation analysis between independent variable and dependent variable. Whichever the variable produces very lesser correlation, you need to throw it away. So these are all the four you can do. Then once if you are building the model, you need to capture the residual error. From the residual error, you need to go for linearity check. You need to go for homoscedasticity versus heteroscedasticity. You need to go for that autocorrelation test. These all those tests you can do for the reliability. Further, you need to do these all. Although you are doing these 4-5 operations, you need to do these all in order to take conclusion and decision based on that confidence interval. So these are all the way you can go with. See, for every variable they are giving confidence interval: intercept, education, wealth. So every variable you can take decision. So this finding this confidence interval only our primary duty for business value or business decisions. So this is what you need to take care of. You need to take care into linear regression. It is inevitable in your second unit. Definitely one question will be there based on linear regression. See, fewest number of explanatory variable that will provide an adequate interpretation of dependent variable. More and more the variable, it will lead to overfit. Neither it should become, see, phase using trend line regression is overfit. Whenever you are going with more number of variables, it will lead to overfit. Neither it should become too low. If it is too low, the number of independent variables are too low, that will lead to underfit. If the number of independent variables are too high, that will lead to overfit. Neither it should become too much of independent variable or very few independent variable, it should become, this is called parameter selection method. So the parameter selection method used and discussed. Actually, in this textbook, these all out of scope. Then we need to rely on machine learning. So from the machine learning point of view, very few is the proposed techniques by this author suits. Rest all, it is out of the scope. Next method, what they are trying to explain is, one is categorical independent variable when it exists in your data set, how to do. Then we need to go for dummy variable. This is a known phenomena when it becomes machine learning as well. So hope that you may be knowing. Look at here, one of the column, MBA, predicting salary. So if you look at here, age and MBA are both are independent variable. Predicting salary is the problem statement. This column belongs to categorical in nature. No yes, no yes combinations are filled here. So how you can work? You need to go for either one-hot encoding or label encoding. What this author says, I'm not sure. Yeah, he is going for label encoding. He is replacing all yes by one value or no by one value. It doesn't matter. We may ask another question. So should I, yes should be one, y should be zero? Not at all. It can be anything. I can represent no by one also, yes by zero also. It doesn't make any big difference. One, zero. Here, suitable to the natural world, they have represented no stands for zero, yes stands for one. But this is good practice. But it doesn't mean that always you should use like this. It will allow for one zero representation also. So this is how you need to build a model whenever the categorical values are involved. Next, categorical variables with more than two levels. So these all level, categorical level encoding. When a categorical variable has k greater than two level, we need to add k minus one additional variables to this method. What is that meaning is, for example, male, female, other gender. This leads to three different variables if I am choosing one-hot encoding. Then this is called gender column in this scenario. This need to be thrown away, then need to be converted into male column, female column, and other gender column. Depending upon every row instance, I need to label, then I need to treat it as 1, 2, 3. Then if in the original record, record number 1 belongs to male category, then I need to put here 1, 0, 0. The second record is belongs to other gender category. 0, 0, 1 I need to put. Third record belongs to female category. I need to put 0, 1, 0. This is called one-hot encoding. So when it becomes more level, if it is two, you can go for both level label encoding. This again, this is a challenge of machine learning enthusiast. You need to find out all the type of encoding, then you need to come out with the improvement of the R square value. We cannot assure which label encoding will best fit for that particular data set. You need to see, they are giving A, B, C, the what I have explained, type B, C, D, one hot encoding based on the given record. So this is how you can do for more than one level. Next, non-linear terms. Depending upon the problem statement and the domain which you are working, you need to come out with the relationship between all the independent variable and the dependent variable. This is very challenging task. Imagine it is not so easy. So this line equation you need to do, or else you yourself, if the error is too huge, you can try with all other non-linear model. So that is another way. This is curve linear regression model. So what is curve linear? Finally, the prediction line would become curve linear. Then rest all would be same. You need to fit the data. Then fitting will lead to R square and adjusted R square. That would become a residual plot. All other rest of the point would become same. So almost your unit number 2, we are done today. We may need to step into unit number 3.